I'm John Stevens, Maple Grove Farm up here in East Central Minnesota, Rock Creek to be exact. And we farm with the soil health principles up here. So we're learning this whole thing. We do the no-till, strip-till, cover cropping, intercropping. We're really changing up. We're going back to the old-fashioned rotation that used to be the area of cattle and legumes to corn and bringing back some cereals and grasses and hays. And the strip-till for our area here has been really phenomenal. The machine that we used was an old Hinneker RM row crop cultivator. So it's got the chisel plow shank, and it already had the nice lead coulter and a nice depth wheel. So the only thing we had to do was add the row cleaner using some receiver hitch pin tubing, and it mounted the row cleaner in the middle, and then the bracket for holding the depth gauge wheels, we just had to modify that bracket, flip it upside down, and that allowed us to lower it to the depth. The birming blades off the back, we borrowed off the old DMI. We don't need that anymore. We got roots and cover crops to do our deep tillage for us now. And so what a great sacrifice that machine made to the cause. And we do have a couple rows, so it's simple. And with the chisel plow shank for our area here, we got a lot of rock. And so with that chisel plow shank, it has a lot of clearance underneath, and it's beefy and heavy, and it handled banging off them rocks good. And the birming discs just float. They're under their own weight. And so for right now, I just use a little piece of jumper chain from side to side, so when we lift up on the headland, they didn't fall down. Just kind of keeping it simple and cheap, and it works great. So if you roll up a big rock, that birming disc can just flip up and over. And for our first design here, we used some old milk pipeline, stainless steel. It's great for dry fertilizer. And the strip till is normally mounted to a Montag, an old Hutchinson Ag Systems fertilizer caddy. And so then we would inject the dry fertilizer down there in that 8-7-8 inch zone, and then your seeds at 2 inches. So we felt we had a good safety buffer there to protect our seedlings, and it seemed to work good because we could chase the strip till machine later that day with the planter, and we never saw germination issues or any burn like that. And so that was pretty good. And the great thing up here was we started in 15, we started trying no-till in 13, 14 we did more no-till, 15 we brought on, 15 we started some strip-till, started cover cropping, and expanded the no-till, and it really shot us along. And the other great part about the strip-till is it cleaned up a lot of them tough soil areas for us. We've got some spots where we have no clay, it's just a sand hole in the soil. And when we were conventional till or no-till, them spots would die up and not do very well. And the strip-till, by having our nutrients in that moist soil down at 8 inches, we always had life and roots around our nutrients. So we noticed a really more even across the fields. And then we're on to something here, And from day one, we cut our P and K and sulfur application rates in half. And then we saved according to University of Iowa, like $40 an acre on tillage costs. So we were on day one, compared to conventional tillage with broadcast fertilizer, we were saving about $100 an acre by going to this guy here. And so in today's world, that's 33 bushels. Cash market down the road in Wisconsin was 270 or 280 something the other morning. So you're talking 35 bushel of corn in savings, and that when you have 140, 150 bushel corn territory, 30 bushels of corn is a lot of corn to put out there just to make the ground warm and dry and black for no reason. And the fertility management side too, then, it's that much less to handle. It's that much less borrowed money. It's that much less interest. And for us here, with limited labor on our small farm. It's fantastic. One machine. Dad can go out with the strip till machine and he can do primary tillage, fertility application, and finishing in one pass, done. And we are literally chasing him with the planter, and we can cover our little acres really quick, fast, and efficient. And so for kind of a no-brainer for us on the strip till side, and I like it. So the next goal for strip till for us would be, can we get a row unit, build a row unit, buy a row unit, get a row unit that can go through sod so we can strip till into a living cover. We want to move to more perennials for cover crops. And I like corn. And with the cover crops, our corn can cash flow quite nice because our cost is coming down. So can we somehow strip till into a living perennial legume grass mix to take advantage of our nitrogen and other credits that are out there, but strip till to give us that zone to protect our cash crop so our cash crop has the best chance it can. And so that to me is a big future goal with the strip till.